Hi, I am Marion Buricatu, a French-American artist. In less than 5 minutes, I'm going to make you an art expert. Just kidding.
Today, I have a special guest, and this special guest is my son, Thomas. Hello, Thomas.
Hello. Hello, everyone. So today, we'll be talking about a painting called The Olive Trees by Georges Braque, a French painter. And he painted this in 1907. And today, it is located at the Worcester Art Museum.
Very nice.
And so, what makes this painting so interesting?
Well, merci for asking this question, Thomas. And I have to say that I even gave it my own title. I changed the title, yes. And my own title is The Inescapable Journey to Abstraction. And why is that? It's because this painting is part of a long journey from classical painting to abstraction. It belongs to an art movement that was called the Fauvism. And Braque, Georges Braque, is considered one of the most important artists in the invention of modern art. So today, we're having only two facts about this painting. So fact number one is Fauvism, and fact number two is influenced by Paul Cézanne.
Okay, so fact number one, Fauvism.
Fauvism was a very short-lived art movement from 1905 to 1908, which means that it lasted only 3 years.
Okay.
But it had a lot of influence on this road towards abstraction.
And in the word Fauvism, you can hear the word fauve, which in French means wild beast. So is that a colorful use of colors?
Yes. This is really the main characteristic of this art movement. It's the treatment of colors. So here is a painting by André Derain, painted in 1906. And this painting is in Washington, D.C. So as you can see, this painting is really colorful. So what does abstraction mean at that time? It's all about finding different ways to express reality.
Okay.
And what is the reality in Fauvism? It's about the emotion, and it's not about what you see in front of you. So
okay, so it's like colors are not used anymore to imitate the nature, but to reveal emotions. It's not about what you see, it's about what you feel.
Yes, it's not about what you see, it's about what you feel.
Okay.
Yes, that's what we're going to
say. Is that very important?
Yes, that's the thing you have to remember about Fauvism.
Okay.
So if you want to be a fauve artist, okay, there are two rules to follow. The first rule is that you have to use pure colors out of the tube. So no mixing.
Is that what happens because of that?
So then the painting is going to be brighter, more colorful.
Okay.
Now the second rule is that if you want to paint the tree trunk in pure black or red, so be it. Because again, it's not about
what you see, it's about what you feel.
Great. And this is particularly true in the south of France where the light is so strong, even violent, you feel the sunburn.
Okay. Fact number two, Braque was influenced by Paul Cézanne.
Yes, so on this road to abstraction, what they really wanted to do, what the artists wanted to do, was to get rid of the structure of things. So what they wanted to do is to simplify to the extreme the shapes and the forms to basic geometric shapes. So for example, in the painting here, the trees are still recognizable, but he chopped the line. And why is that? It's because he wanted to simplify, but we are still at the beginning on this road to abstraction. Cézanne, Paul Cézanne, was really the first one to do that. And Braque really wanted to follow in his footstep. So he decided to paint in the town of Cézanne, close to Marseille, in the south of France, to understand and to immerse himself into Cézanne's world.
Okay, so that means that if Braque is the father of modern art, then Cézanne is the grandfather?
Yes, absolutely. And it's about Braque pursuing the search for abstraction that was started by Cézanne. So the next year, in 1908, he will give up Fauvism to create this new major art movement that, with Picasso, and you know how it's called.
Is it Cubism?
Yes, bravo.
So here are the two facts easy to remember. Fact number one, Fauvism. And fact number two, Georges Braque influenced by Paul Cézanne.
Yes, so now if you want to learn more about Georges Braque and Fauvism, please don't forget to look at the link below. Also, the next video is just for you because I have created 6 awesome trivia questions about Georges Braque to have fun with your friends and family anytime.
Nice chatting with you. Abonne-toi, which means subscribe to my channel in French. Have fun and see you at the next video. Bye-bye.